Azure SQL capacity planning is very important to make sure you're optimizing not only your costs, but also your performance. In this video, we'll dive into an overview of what that entails. Hi, welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, we're going to be talking about an overview of Azure SQL capacity planning. And today, I'm lucky to have with me, joined all the way from Italy, Silvano, PM on the Azure SQL database team. Thanks for joining us today.
Thanks a lot, Hannah, for having me. Glad to be here.
Awesome. And, you know, just to kick this off and kind of set some ground setting, I wanted to ask, you know, when we talk about capacity planning, what does that really mean and why is it important?
Yeah, I mean, capacity planning is the process where you are actually trying to estimate and figure out what is the required amount of resources in your system to be able to run a given workload. So every time you are designing and implementing a brand new application, and you are thinking about the deployment phase when your applications will actually go to production, or every time you are planning to move from an existing system to a different one, like, for example, from your on-premises deployment for SQL Server into Azure SQL Database, you need to actually start thinking about, you know, what will be the amount of resources and sizing and effectively capacity planning will be needed in order to make sure your deployments will be successful.
Awesome. Okay. I mean, it seems straightforward enough. Like any type of product or process, we want to make sure that we're planning appropriately and we have the right capacity for the workloads that we're running. Now, when it comes specifically to Azure SQL Database, what are some of the things that, you know, someone should consider?
Yeah, especially for people coming from the traditional on-premises space where you have a potential infinite set of options in terms of configuring your hardware, your kind of system, things like the amount of SSD disks that you are throwing into your system, you know, the storage configuration, CPUs and such. When it comes to a PaaS offer like Azure SQL Database, you have a set of kind of bundled offers where you have to select from a reduced amount of options and flavors, right? So the ability to translate from an existing system that is sitting in your own data center into this set of predefined bundles in terms of resources like CPU cores, memory, and IO is critical, actually, and is the most complex decision that you have to take.
Thanks, Silvano. It seems like this is a really important decision. Can you kind of walk us through some of the things or dimensions that we should consider?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. And in a PaaS offering like Azure SQL Database, we have this kind of reduced set of options where we can decide basically on which one to deploy our workloads, right? And those dimensions generally are starts from the deployment options that we have available in Azure SQL Database. So we can pick up from single database instances, Elastic Pool, where we have a group of databases that are sharing the same set of resources. We also have the new serverless compute tier available, where you can basically accommodate spiky workloads and let the service itself to manage things like auto-scaling and always using the right amount of resources behind the scenes. And we have Azure SQL Managed Instance for customers that wants to basically have the closest behaviors to the traditional instance-based SQL Server deployments that we know and love on-premises. Right, so once we decide which one to pick between these deployment options, we moved into this concept of purchasing models. And we are offering two models here because one, the DTU stands for database throughput units is targeting customers that are brand new into their own applications, and they don't have existing set of references, like you know, an existing system with a given amount of cores, memory, and I/O configuration. But they just are thinking in terms of what is, you know, the amount of concurrent users that I have, and how many transactions per second they are expected to run against my system. So DTU is a model which is designed around this concept of simplifying essentially the configuration of your Azure SQL database instance by picking up the amount of throughput units that you will need. The vCore purchasing model is instead much more similar to what you typically do in your on-prem space, where you buy a given amount of cores, memory, and I/O throughput, and then you can, for example, compare and contrast with what you have on-prem and start the sizing process from there. The next step and next dimension in this process is to try to figure out if what is the service tier or the level of service that we are expecting from our database. And in the DTU purchasing model, we are basically classifying our service tiers between basic, standard, and premium. So we're basic, as the name implies. You are, you know, there's the minimum amount of resources available for you, while the premium is offering much more kind of resources and throughput units for running your databases. On the vCore-based purchasing model, we are dividing essentially those service tiers in general purpose and business critical. And again, general purpose is for running your kind of regular database workload, while business critical is offering reduced latency and a number of advanced characteristics, even in terms of feature set. Hyperscale is the new service tier that we've been introducing recently, which is actually providing a brand new storage engine into the Azure SQL world, and is actually promising infinite scale in terms of data volume that it can accommodate, and basically giving you the ability to scale to your largest workloads, actually. So for all these different service tiers, we have different compute sizes that are effectively defining the amount of resources like CPU, storage, and memory you will get. And each of these compute sizes comes with its own set of resource limits and characteristics, right? So the capacity planning process in Azure SQL DB will, at the end, require you to pick up between these different dimensions the ones that is effectively capable of running your workload now and in the future.
Thanks, Silvano. That was really useful to see kind of how these different choices are broken down. But really, we're just kind of skimming the surface on this topic, right?
Absolutely. And over the next episodes in this series, we will go through some practical recommendations and suggestions on how to basically go through this capacity planning process in order to get the amount of information you need before you are actually deploying your Azure SQL database instances.
Awesome. Well, thanks so much, Silvano. And if you like this video, please like this video, leave us a comment, and stay tuned for the next part in Azure SQL Capacity Planning.